coding series where we have been creating a website from scratch with Python, Django, and Wagtail CMS. Today, we're going to continue the bookstore feature of the Western Friend website. As you can see on the screen, we're going to be working with flat rate shipping. I believe the best place for this to reside is going to be on the orders, the order class. Sort of a method there, like we have to get total cost, we can do get shipping cost. Probably want a library here, or module, for shipping. And specifically, we're just going to look at book shipping. And flat rate means the same shipping for each item, shipping cost, so it's not based on weight. But we, in our case, offer discounts for larger orders. So more items means less shipping cost. So I'm not really sure of a great approach to this, aside from just something pretty basic. I think I'm just going to use Python doesn't have switches, so just an if-else, or an if, series of ifs. And just be very careful that they're correct. But if anyone watching has a suggestion of a better implementation, I'm really eager to learn. I've thought about using the Python range function, because basically we have ranges of values, numbers of items, so we can, for one book, charge €4 shipping, or $4 shipping. For 2 to 4 books, we could charge $3 each. I think it's each item. Double check these rules real quick. The shipping cost is applied to each line item. So I'll work out the specifics of the shipping costs with Mary. I just don't have an underlying implementation. All right, so let's go ahead and dig in. All right, darn it. Okay, so for right now, just gonna pass or return. Just say 10. And what did my environment activate? Let's go ahead and load the server up. I believe already on the cart. Let me think for a second. I have to figure out where to show the shipping. Because at this point on the cart, we don't have a shipping value. We don't have an order created yet until they click checkout. So let's just go ahead and keep it with that. I think Mary said this would be okay. And what would this look like in the template? So we'll come over here to the order template. It would say create. And over here, we'll just duplicate this. So then now need to be updated to get subtotal. Shipping zero. Get shipping. Ah, interesting. So the cart actually does have the method for shipping. Which is fine. I mean, sorry, not shipping, but the total price. Which also the order does. I'll double check here if the order should be in context. Well, okay, so I'll just retract that. I will add the flat rate shipping here. And we'll use a library so that the code is the same in both places. Okay, good to go. So let's hop back over to the cart. I just have to think where this should live then. Since this is being shared between two apps, cart and orders, I might just create another app, shipping. Let's go ahead and do that. This isn't a regular app. So I'll delete the, it's not going to have a model, for example. We might not even need migrations. Shipping model. Unless we do end up adding shipping rules, like that can be defined through the user interface. That would be a long-term goal. But it's too complicated for me to think about right now. So what I'm going to do is register this. I'm not even sure if we need to register the shipping app, to be honest. Products, because it can be multiple types in the cart. Okay. I think it's a flower. I don't know if it needs to be a quote. So let's come back to this. Just have to run the full screen mode. Library. The template for this should be working out. Right, sorry. Let me think here. This is the create order though. I want the cart template detail. Yeah, cool. And we've got it done. So we'll need a subtotal, shipping cost, and then total. Good stuff. We need this total price should actually be subtotal price. List. I believe some takes a list, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. List or tuple would be fine here. Okay. And What's the Python null? None. Int and method. Okay, there we go. Oh, gotta try not to call these. Looking good. So more or less, I think that'll be good. Just a little tweak here. I'll come to this in a moment. Bootstrap. Alright, text alignment. Justify text right, okay. That if I can just do this 5, let's see how that looks. Basically what I'm after, yeah. Yeah, I guess italics is not a weight, is it? That makes sense. Alright. Good to learn. I should probably be doing this. This works. It breaks stuff. Alright, seems to be working. Very cool. All right, that's a good thing to learn about the decimal library in the quantize method. Interesting. All right, that way it's more natural, and apparently it'll make the arithmetic more human-friendly. I like that philosophy. Okay, so let's go to checkout and get this shipping displaying correctly here, and then I'll get into the library a little bit. Just a little bit of tea first. Okay, so this order detail is also pulling in. Sorry, the order create. It's also pulling in some information from the cart. I should probably display this as a table also. We'll come back to that. Now, essentially, what we're going to do inside of this calculator is set up some breakpoints. Now I'm done with these templates. And I need to pass in this get booking book shipping cost from, sorry, I need to import this book shipping cost from the shipping module, shipping app, and I need to pass in these items to the function. Why is this not? That's been a typo. Alright, cool. Now, here's where I'm not sure how to work things out. But my general idea is that I'll look at the items, I'll grab the list of items inside of this function, and for each of those I will check if it's an instance of the book class, which is defined in the products module. If so, I'll set the one aside into a like a placeholder array or a list, and then I'll iterate over that list. I'll look at the length of that list more or less, or I can just, so I don't need the list, I believe, just count. So let me just type that out. Get product, so that should already be coming in there. Through here. Product's not none. I don't know why this would ever be none, but okay, there it is. Shipping rules are just like I said earlier. It's like if it's one book, it's $4. If it's 2 to 4 books, it's $3 each book. Yeah. We'll get into the nuance of that in a moment. So I wanted to try this out. And grab an order. Oh, that's good, that's what I want. Yeah, so I should be able to access property like the model. Oh, okay, right, because if I'm going to order, yes, I need to go to the product. All right, no problem. So I got to get my bearings. Instance type. So how do you just check Python? I think just type. Here's where the immutability bites me. In other words, we decided to make these order items immutable so that the data in the database could change, the related products could change price-wise, even the title. So this is static. It's not actually referring to the other, to what the product is. So to fix this, I just need to get make some change to my model real quick, hopefully real quick. And either product type field that could be static, or actually just a foreign key relationship. I believe that's what I'll do, is do the proper foreign key. It's already bit me once, not doing the foreign key. So, okay. To do that, we need to track it down. Go up at a higher level, but it looks like I've already got the product ID here. This might be a smaller distinguish them from the cart to the order. In this case, I'll have an iterable. query set. So then essentially need the product ID when saving the cart to an order. So that occurs in the view. Create order post. So when we're calling this for item in cart, we're actually invoking this iter function. And what this does is stores the title, the stringified version of the product. It calls this dunder str method. Hey, Linge Productions. Thanks for hosting. Appreciate it. So I'm just trying to figure out the most kind of clean way of getting this product ID into this context here. And this iterator. Hey, what's up, Aiden Linge? Hope I'm saying your name right. How are you doing today? Cool. You do much work with Python or web development? All right, that's cool. Yeah, I'm always just starting at two, so no worries there. You'll have lots to learn. What kind of project are you aspiring to build? That's the probably one of the key questions. You got any ideas you're thinking about building? Here's what I'm starting to think though. This card is a copy here. And all I'm using it for, it's basically just a dictionary. I don't think I need to really do anything with it. I believe I could just do this directly in the product for product and products. If I do something like this. See how badly this breaks things, but yeah. Aiden Lynch says, just a normal website for the Lynch Productions channel. That's what they're working on. Cool. All right, so let's just clean up this. This is a website for a nonprofit organization. We're porting it over from Drupal. And we've done a lot of this stuff over the last about 4, almost 5 years now, through the Drupal admin UI, point and click. You can do quite a lot, and we've made little and big changes. We're porting it over to Python and Django and Wagtail. It's got a lot of different features. Right now, we're working on the bookstore. And so I've kind of got a basic thing working here in the bookstore. I hope my code is not too broken at this point, but yeah. Yeah, cool, thanks. So what I'm seeing here, this could be product price, then this could be product price. Oh, this could then just be item price. Do anything with this actually. Oops, sorry for bumping the mic. Okay, so yeah, just right now I'm working on some code I inherited from this really good book. If you're interested in building app, I'm not sure if you're using Python. There it goes. There's this open source book on Pact Publishing. The book source code is here under MIT license. And through the process of reading this book, you end up building several different applications, an e-commerce site, social kind of networking and sharing site, e-learning. And so I, since the code is open source, was using some of it here. I just got it. Having not written it, this is one of the few parts of this R project where I haven't really done most of the code. What's the name of the book that you've got? That's huge. 1874 pages PDF about how to create a site in Django. Yeah, quite extensive. There's this Wagtail CMS. If you're just kind of doing a promotional website, oh yeah, there's a Udemy course you're taking. Great. Yeah, I've got a few. I think Pact has even started publishing a lot of their video courses on Udemy as well. If you want to get just a slightly higher level abstraction away from even some of the niceties of Django, this Wagtail CMS is a great entry into Django web development. It's like WordPress for Django in a way. It gives you this really nice admin user interface. If I hop over to the front page, Wagtail admin, all this is built just pretty much by default with Wagtail and a few modifications. You can create custom menus, like flyout menus and things like that, and just different tables to display. Well, this is a bad example because I haven't created the content, but let me show you in our store where I'm working right now. You know, I created this custom display for books, and then we can check the orders. I can filter by whether or not they're paid, search for specific orders. All this is done automatically in Wagtail with just a little bit of code. So it's really been a great developer experience. And it's just Django underneath, so you can always get down into some of the Django level stuff, you know, or in Python. So this is just a Python class here, heading from object, which is actually just what I was basically, it's not a dictionary, right? It's just a, so I've just got to figure out a way to change this iterate function. I think the data structure it's looking for is just a dictionary. And what kind of database are you using for uploading a whole website? For the production website, we'll be using Postgres. It's really good. I mean, just a great database. But, you know, with Django, you can use MySQL. As of like recently, MariaDB is first class support. I believe it's for Django 3 though. Maybe it was. So you've got some good choices here. Django 3's not been released yet. We're still a ways off on that. December 2019. But for all intents and purposes, so to speak, I believe Postgres is a great way to start. AWS's got some great qualities too. Partially that it's governed by a foundation. In any case, if you're interested in checking out Wagtail, the tryout Wagtail is really quick, and this course is free. This Learn Wagtail course. I don't know how recently it was made free, but it's been free as long as I've seen it. It's got a whole bunch of video lessons. They're all on YouTube as well, but it's just a little bit better presentation on this website. Learnwagtail.com. I'm not affiliated with them. I'm not making any affiliate money or anything like that. That's not a paid endorsement. It's just something that's been helpful to me along the way. All right. So I believe we're gonna be okay here to just have a dictionary. And one moment, I'll be right back. Okay, thank you for bearing with me. So, yeah, my son woke up and he just wanted to see what I was up to, and I kind of went, helped him get settled back into bed. Yeah, this is the main thing. I didn't write this code, and I'm not fully confident it will work when I refactor, but from what I can tell, should be just a dictionary is all that we need here. This is card values, where was that created? And I will need to make one change to the model here. Now that I was thinking about it for a moment, I would like to make two changes. One is the product name, and one is the product ID. Just go back here to item. Item. Aiden, hey, nice to meet you, and good luck on your endeavors. Let me see, what was the name of your project? Linge Productions. I'll look forward to seeing what you come up with. Do you have a website, lingeproductions.com or something? Just out of curiosity, I can give it a shout out. Just a plan, hey. Well, that's all good. See, it looks like I can't simply go by the products. That was what I was kind of worried about. The item itself. Alright, so let me just back up a little bit. Quite a bit. these items are actually loaded with a little bit more information that I need. Dang. So I do need to create a copy of the cart. String there. That's kind of strange. If I can add this product here. Just to clean up this code a little bit. This needs to be, I'm not sure why the original author made this a string, if it's something to... With this getting serialized on the server, this is quite strange. But I believe now we should be good on the iterator at least. What I need to do is create another cart to test this out. I just kind of just lost all my beers. That's funny. It's all right. This is all working. That's a good checkpoint. I need to commit this. Let me see if this was the breaking. Okay, so that's why. So that's probably the underlying error. It was about the serialization. So, all right, good to know. Just the other error was a little bit misleading. Actually coming along pretty good. So this has to be string, has to be JSON serializable. That's why they're doing it. Couldn't a float work here though? I'll have to leave it alone, but that doesn't mean I have to. Have only these fields. I just have to use the JSON serializable equivalents. Safe. And then I'll need this make some changes throughout. So this is all refactored to title. I'm just gonna break my previous orders. Django's good about that. Make those migrations automatically. Even renaming columns in the database, pretty slick. That means we're gonna have some troubles in our templates real quick. I'll have to fix those if I, for example, look in Wagtail admin, and we're not running the server anymore. just need to work my way up the chain. It looks like we're in the model first. This could be coming out of the template, though, to be honest. So that wasn't too bad. There's just a couple of fields in here. I suppose okay. Yeah. So we just changed product title, and made migration. In the add function, when we add something to the cart, it'll get those properties, which means in this iterator method we don't need to do this anymore. We don't need to add this field, it's already there. So that's a little bit better cleanup. I like that. We're going to work on a copy of the cart so we can mutate these items without it affecting the original. Okay, everything else looks good. What else did I want to add? I just needed to, the main reason we're doing all this is so that I can get those product IDs and check which ones of those are books. Cool. Cleaning up the code along the way. lost here. I just need to reboot my brain for a moment. Also, my son is having trouble sleeping, so I'm going to go and see if I can help him get to sleep. I may be back on in a little bit. Otherwise, I'll continue this another day. This has been another episode of Building a Website from Scratch with Python, Django, and the Wagtail CMS. I appreciate everybody who's stopped in on the live stream and hope to see you all around. Have a great day.